Good morning, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. Here we have a live view of Old Faithful Geyser. Looking back on the upper geyser basin. It's currently 9:32 a.m. It's 55 degrees there today. Supposed to have thunderstorms there. And I think the high is only going to be in the 60s there. There's been several earthquakes there at Yellowstone. And I was watching yesterday. I didn't do a report. But, we got some new screaming from the volcano in the northeastern location of Yellowstone. Little West Thumb, which is there at Yellowstone Lake, you know, has been screaming. You can see the indications here. And then also, yesterday there at Pelican Cone, there was screaming going on also. And we got some earthquakes that USGS so far today has not reported. Well, it's early. Maybe they'll do it later. Soda Butte yesterday also had a lot of activity. Look at that. Yep, and we can see the earthquakes that were happening there. As you know, the continent, as it moves southwest a bit, the hot spot remains in the same place as the earth of the crust moves in that direction. So the hot spot for the caldera is actually gives it the impression that it's moving northeast. So this is the area where all the activity was happening yesterday, and I was watching it. Yeah, along with Little West Thumb. USGS is only reporting one earthquake in the last 24 hours. All earthquakes, a magnitude 2.6 by Stanley, Idaho, which is today at 10:13 Universal Time. They're saying it was 6.2 miles below sea level. That's the location, but none of the others are reporting. I downloaded three different monitors. We got Pelican Cove. We have the bore hole for the Madison River area in the center. And on the right, Little West Thumb. The strongest signature for this most recent earthquake that shows up on all three monitors comes from Little West Thumb. And we'll make that bigger right there. And we'll bring it down. It comes in as a magnitude 3.0, maybe a 5 on this monitor. And we'll go to the seismic signature right there. Not being reported. We got another one marked in red for this location right there. Let's go back to this other one to get the time. Okay, 9:23 Universal Time. Like I said, it's a magnitude 3.0. So that would have been at 4:13 a.m. And you can see we got rounded tops. I'm not surprised. We got magma coming into the system. Yeah, it was really active yesterday. Yeah, look at that. And it's still active today. Not quite as active. Or maybe the dike intrusion found a different spot for it to come in. A little bit closer to the lake. But yeah, rounded tops. Harmonic tremors right there. And volcanic tremors. Comes in, let me bring it down. As a magnitude 1.77. And then we got another one marked in red. Here for Little West Thumb. And we'll make that bigger. Alright, this one does show up on all three monitors right there. I'll have to bring this one over a little bit farther, it looks like. Here we got Pelican Cove. All right, right there, Pelican Cove. This one here is the bore hole. You can see it picked it up on the bore hole for the Madison River. And this one here is Little West Thumb. Little West Thumb has it marked in red. And we'll make that bigger. And we'll bring it down. And it comes in as a magnitude 1.98. Not being reported as of yet. All right, 8:19. Here's the screaming that I was talking about, where it was coming in so hard and fast there at Little West Thumb. Let me bring this up. that it couldn't record the signature at certain points. Yeah, we got hot magma. Look at that. That was coming in 8:18 Universal Time, 3:13 a.m. And yeah, look at this hole. Let me go back here if I can get the line. Okay. I keep going off the line. Here you can see there was popping of the rock during that time. And a lot of hot magma came up. Let me show you something. This is the area for the West Thumb Caldera. And as you know, we got this crack very deep there at Yellowstone Lake. Probably 430, maybe 390 feet. Yeah, deep. But this area here only erupted less than 10,000 years ago. Yeah, not very long ago. And they got rhyolite flows in this area. So it's interesting that this monitor would be picking up magma trying to come up in this area. And I've talked about the area of Grant where it's been trying to come up. And yeah, to see that it's screaming there is a little concerning, especially also we know that we got magma that comes up from probably the Gulf of California, comes up along Yellowstone, along this side of the lake, and then up in this area, which would be the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome. Over here we have Mary Lake, which was showing activity also yesterday. And this is the area for Pelican Cone. Many of you who follow me will remember when they had the 4.2 earthquake over here. That was on May 11th of this year. Anyways, this is the area where the magma comes up from the Gulf of California and then moves across, goes under the lake, and then comes up in the Madison River area. That's the data that they have so far about what is happening there at Yellowstone. And this is the area where the hot spot, the direction that the hot spot is moving. Here at Pelican Cone, the monitor, you can see we got lots marked in red. I want to check this out right there if I can get it. Yeah, see that, what was happening earlier? Yeah, this is what I was watching yesterday. Now, this was 16:02 Universal Time. So that would have been 11:13 a.m. yesterday. We got another little spot maybe right there. 11:27 a.m. Let's see what else we got here, more recent maybe. All right, 23:09. Let's look at the signature because it looks a little blank. Yeah, right there. Okay, 23:09. I tried to make it a little bit bigger for you. That would have been at 6:13 p.m. last night. Again, there's the spectrogram. It was popping of the rock, what it was. 11:59. For some reason, it wasn't recording, but yeah, I don't know. Let's go to the signature. There it is. Yeah, it just stopped recording. I don't know why. That would have been 6:59 a.m. today. Let's take a look here and see what we got going here. You can see too, we got the line of melt very close to the crust of the earth. I already did that one, but we'll go to that one again. And this is what it was showing when I pulled the files. Let me show you. We got another earthquake that came in at about 14:20. You can see it on all three monitors. That would have been at a little after 9:20 a.m. today. Okay, so at the bottom, we got the borehole for the Madison River area. You can see it there. This here is Little West Thumb. And the one at the top is Pelican Cove. At about 3:15 a.m., you can see we got Little West Thumb here. No sign of magma intrusion for Pelican Cove, but we do have it for Little West Thumb. And let me go back another couple hours. Three earthquakes at, well, all three monitors at 6:14 Universal Time. I already showed you that one, I believe. More popping of the rock here at Little West Thumb. Right there, 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 where magma, yeah, is coming into the system. Let me go back. All right, and this is blobs of magma. And then up here at Pelican Cove, that's the one I believe I already showed you where the magma was coming in at about 21:30 Universal Time. All right, we'll go back another 4 hours, see what we got here. Okay, so here we got Little West Thumb, the top, Pelican Cove, the bottom, Madison River. Yeah, more earthquakes. Yeah, look at that. Okay, let's check this out. At 19, well, I think I showed you that 55. I don't know. No, I didn't. Okay, and this is it right there. Yeah, look at that. Yeah, a lot of heated water coming up. The rocks have increased their melt. I don't see magma that came up, but yeah. Let's go to the seismic signature. Drum beats. Yeah, look at that. All right, we'll pull it over. Very concerning. And we'll go back another 4 hours. Yeah, see all that at Pelican Cove? Oh my goodness. Okay, 1500. And then see that? Yeah, okay, and that would be the 1600 line. All right, so that would be all within that area here. You can see 1530. Let's see if we can find out. Yeah, see that? Yep. 1558. Let's see if I can stay on the line. Sometimes it's hard for me to stay on the line. Look at all that coming up. There it. I went off the line. That's all right, but it shows it there. Okay. We'll go across. Yeah, there's nothing to see. If Yellowstone decides to erupt, it's only going to change the climate for the Earth. Nothing will grow. We'll go into a mini ice age. Yeah. Okay, let's try and go here. Go down a little. Oop, I went down too far. Okay. Okay, 16, 18. Sorry about that. Yeah, my grandson, he's playing his game. So it looks like this activity was going on probably for about, let me go down and see if I can see anything down here, for about 2 hours. Yeah, see how the magma came up? And then it heated up the water. Steam, gases came up afterwards. See that? And we got this one here. Yeah. Something happened there at 1458 where, it went blank. Oh, let me make that bigger. All right, right there. Now, the University of Utah should have seen this last night. Should have been watching this yesterday. Yesterday was Friday. This would have been Friday. Today's Saturday. The 6th of August, they should have been watching this. Of course, they go home at 5 o'clock. So, yeah. Being the weekend, there's probably nobody there. Yeah. Very concerning. So if you want, you can go to the thumbnails. Let me go back over there. And keep an eye on this area. And we got Mirror Lake Plateau, Pelican Cove, Soda Butte, Parker Peak. Now, this is all the area for the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome. This here is the borehole. A lot of times the boreholes don't work. 208. And you can click on it and it'll show you This is actually for Yellowstone Lake, and often it's not working. See how it's, this is what it's currently showing there for Yellowstone Lake. Let me bring this down a little bit. Yeah. This one I did not download. I wanted to get a broad view of what's going on at Yellowstone, but there is five here marked in red. One there, two, three, four, looks like five marked in red. And this is Grant. Now Grant, like I said, is the area where it looked like magma was trying to come up there. We got a weakening of the crust. Grant is now open for camping and, you know, staying at the hotel and all that. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Keep on prepping. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.